Welcome back to Clean Phil Wanted. It is the second episode of The Most Useless Machine. For the last episode, I made most of the box with all hand tools, but this episode we're going to be fixing up the lid and attaching it to the box itself, as well as finally doing the electronics inside. I'm going to try to do my best to explain it and keep this a brief video. A few things about this ahead of time. What you're going to see me do is saw the lid in half. The lid does have an angle on it so that it closes easier. Make sure you do that with whatever box you're using. I didn't glue the sides to the bottom. It's actually screwed in there with a board going across the center, so it can be removed. That allows other people, whoever has this in the future, to take it apart and get to the electronics and a battery case inside. I've been wanting to make one of these for 15, 20 plus years, ever since I saw them as a little kid. But I will tell you that I did get the wiring schematics from an Instructables page, so I am gonna put a link at least in the description to where that page is. Please go check them out. I wanna thank them for having it up there and send them the traffic that they deserve, in my opinion. The first thing you're going to need is a 2 AA cell battery case. Now you don't really need this, but for safety reasons, I added in this on-off switch. This switch is a dual pull, dual throw toggle switch. The toggle at the top only has two positions, and on the bottom, you're going to see six tabs. The next switch is a single pull, dual throw micro switch with a lever. It will have a lever on the top and three tabs on the bottom. And the last thing we need is some sort of geared motor. We're going to modify the servo by opening it up, pull the electronics out of the bottom, and solder two wires directly into the motor. Modifying the gears at the top is finding the largest gear that has a tab on it. Remove that so that it can rotate freely all the way around. You want to use a hacksaw to cut it off. I pulled the wires from some old junk electronics that I had laying around. Make sure that all the wires are longer than you think you need. The first thing to do is wire the motor to the two middle tabs on the DPDT switch. The next thing I did was wire the battery case to one side of the switch. When this toggle is flipped, we want to reverse the polarity, so wire one tab to the opposite tab on the opposite side. If you have an alligator clip, you should clip it onto that second tab on the first side and go to its opposite on the opposite side. That's what we want, but we needed to know when to stop. So we're gonna remove that second wire and we're gonna attach it to the single polarity dual throw micro switch. I do want it to turn the power off when the lever is depressed. So I'm going to wire mine to the first and third tabs. You might want to test this. To keep my life simple, and because I'm not used to this kind of stuff, I am going to attach all these components with a hot melt glue gun. That'll give me the freedom to alter things as needed. I wasn't sure about the shape of the lever that goes on the servo, so I just cut pieces of cardboard and glued them together with a hot melt until I came up with a shape that was close enough. And then I cut that out and shaped it up.
I made it way more complicated than I needed to, but I'll take it.